How's everyone feeling today?
Good.
Good. I'm glad to hear that. So I'm Addie, and welcome to part two of our series, Young and Bold. We're doing all summer just talking about, or we're kind of going off the verse, 1 Timothy 4:12, which is saying, like, just because we're young doesn't mean we can't set an example. We need to show an example in different ways to other believers. And so what I'm talking about this week is to set an example by the way that you live, by your conduct, the way you act. And so when thinking of ways that I act, when thinking of just how I am, my personality, you have to go all the way back, right? Because the way you're raised influences how you act when you're older. So I went all the way back to when I was little, just thinking about, like, you know, like things that would influence me, like the culture I grew up in. And I was actually listening to some of the songs that we used to listen to when we were kids. And so I noticed a common theme that just, like, I don't know, it just came up a lot, and kind of like, I don't know, I could see how these songs shaped me. So I actually made a little mix of them so that you can just hear what I'm talking about. So Ben, you can go try to think of the common theme that I would have found when listening to these songs.
Every inch of you is perfect from the bottom to the top.
Who in the world? Who in the world? Baby, you're a star. You are. Come on, let your colors burst. Make them go out. You're gonna leave them all in there.
Hey, you better be ready. I bet you feel the same.
So what was, like, the common theme? Did anyone actually listen?
Women.
Women? What else? What else? Yeah, lots of women. I heard someone say it. I don't know who said it.
Confidence.
Confidence. It was all about, mainly, I'm sorry guys, but I am female. So it was about empowering women. Like, go women. I don't, you hear Ben say it all the time. It was just one of those things that it just, like, really built you up. But the problem of what comes when you really build people up is their egos build up. And because of that, I would say after, like, growing up in that kind of culture, I was a very self-absorbed child, and I'm sure plenty of us were. It's human nature. But so this is just an example in my life of how I was a self-absorbed child. So I was the kid that would throw a tantrum over everything. My sister can testify to that. She complains about it all the time. But it was my way or no way. I always wanted to stand out because I was taught to be confident, right? And so I always wore, like, the stuff that made me stand out. When I was 4, I wanted to dress up as a bride for Halloween because I knew that that was the one person that everyone looked at, like, on their wedding day. And so I was like, ooh, like, I'm gonna dress like that. So just, like, things can really influence us, and they can cause us to be, like, very selfish, I would say. Like, just the way the culture is, the way the world is, it wants you to think you're perfect the way you are, like, you need to stand out wherever you go. And although this can be very powerful, it can also be taken in a really bad way. And so I do have a story of my, like, in my childhood. When I was, I'd say 7, my mom's favorite holiday is International Pancake Day. And so every year we would go to IHOP, and we would go, and she would get her short stack of pancakes, and she'd have them heat up the syrup, and they'd all be like, what are you heating up the syrup? Anyway, that's a different story. But she always made us do this every year. And so we're sitting at IHOP, we're eating our pancakes, and we get up to go, and my mom, we see this table next to us. And there's this man sitting there, and he's handicapped, and a woman was there taking care of him. And so my mom sees this, and so she asked if she could pay for their meal. Like, she asked the waiter. And so the waiter gave her their bill, and we're leaving. And I'm like, first of all, I think it's cool that this has happened, but, like, I'm just, like, really shocked. Because as a 7-year-old, as a self-absorbed child, I'm sitting there thinking, like, why are we just leaving? And so I looked up at my mom, and I was like, well, how are they supposed to know it was you who paid for their bill? And she was like, no, like, sweetie, like, that's not the reason that we do things. That's not why you serve God. And it was just like, it was, I couldn't figure out why she would do such a bold action and want no credit for it. And so that's just like what we grow up with, things that influence us. They can make us very selfish and kind of thinking about ourselves. And so I actually was thinking, I mean, I don't really believe in coincidences. I think that God puts certain things in our lives for a reason, helps us remember things for a reason. First of all, I have a horrible memory. If you know anything about me, I cannot remember the thing you just said to me. And so it's just cool to me that out of all, like, I remember that day so specifically. I remember what I was wearing. I remember what day of the week it was. And so I always think it's just a cool thing that God wanted me to learn from that. God wanted me to figure out what it was like to serve him selflessly. And so I looked through the Bible to find a story that really went with this whole idea of standing up for God, being bold in actions for God selflessly. And so I came up with the story, or not I came up with, but I found the story of Shadrach. Oh, did one of my slides get deleted? Oh, okay, I'll just read it to you. So of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. So I'll just read it off my little paper here. I was prepared. So just some background information of this story. I mean, you probably all heard this story in Sunday school at least once in your lifetime. So, yeah, oh my goodness, thanks, Jack. Okay, so, go Jack. So, some background, King Nebuchadnezzar was this, like, big guy. He wanted everyone to look at him. He was just that kind of guy. And so he set up this big image of gold for people to worship. And so when they heard any kind of music, they had to immediately fall down and worship this image of gold. So, I mean, yeah, you can tell he's selfish just from that. But it was just very, like, you know, he just wanted people to see him. And he wanted it so much that he said if you didn't bow down to this image of gold, then he would throw you into a blazing furnace. So, it's like, it reminded me of the game This or That. This or That. You can bow down to this big scary dude, or you can have death by fire. So, it was kind of like the people had a very scary choice. But if you break down these choices a little more, then you can kind of see what I'm talking about right now. So, first of all, this choice, if you choose side number one, then you're choosing to give up your beliefs. This guy wanted them to worship him. He wanted him to worship his gods and just completely abandon their own faith, put their little, you know, like when Rocky used to talk about wearing the Jesus jacket, take off their Jesus jackets and fit in. The other option, the death by fire, although scary, this is the option where you defend your faith. This is the option where you stand up and you say, I am a believer of God and I'm not going to put up with this. So I know that this is an extreme example of what I'm about to tie it into, but I do believe that God's word is living and active and it can apply to anything in our lives if you look for it. So in our society today, I would compare this to our choice is to conform to society or to risk our social lives. On this side, with to conform to society, we like to live comfortably. We like to, when we hear about, you know, that kid over there, like what Carter's talking about, when the kid over there is cussing or saying bad things about his friends, we just kind of sit there. We're like, okay, like this is fine. You maybe talk bad about someone else too. Or the other side is to risk our social lives. This is to stand up for what you believe in, and that kid over there is judging you. He's like, ooh, why am I friends with him? He's over there talking about Jesus. Like, that's kind of weird. And so we're constantly given this choice of we can choose to put away, take off our Jesus jacket, put it all away, or we can risk our social lives. We can, you know, we can have the death of our social lives, like the death by fire. And we can stand up for what we believe in, which can be kind of scary. So, but this is not how the story ends, as you may know, with Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. So these three men decided that they were not going to bow. They were not going to put up with this. They were God-following men. They were going to stand up for God. And these were Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And so King Nebuchadnezzar was just so furious that these men were standing up to him. And so he decided that he was going to interrogate them because he didn't know why they were doing this. And so this brings me to Daniel 3:17-18. It says, if we are thrown into a blazing furnace, the God that we serve is able to deliver us from it, and he will deliver us from your majesty's hand. But even if he does not, we want you to know, Your Majesty, that we will not serve your gods or worship the image of gold that you have set up. But even if he does not, I just love how this is put, because it says, if even if he does not, they have so much faith that God is going to deliver them from this. They know that they're just so faithful and trusting in God that they think God's going to save them from this fire because they trust in him. But they're so strong in their beliefs, and they're so strong in standing up for their faith that they say, even if something horrible happens to us, we're still going to stand up for God because that's what we believe in. And so it's all about having strength in your faith. When you do these bold actions and go against the social norm, if you have strength behind you, then you'll be able to say, even if he does not, even if God doesn't save me from this, I'm still going to do it because I trust God, because I know that God is the good side and God is going to help me no matter what. And so I just think this is so powerful how they were saying this. And so next, they were thrown into the fire. This is kind of bad, but it doesn't end like that. So King Nebuchadnezzar was furious with their answer. He had the furnace turned up 7 times hotter. The men who threw Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego in this fire were actually killed by how hot the flames were. And so as King Nebuchadnezzar looked into the fire, he looked around and noticed that there were 4 men walking around in the fire. He was just astonished by this because he could not understand. I mean, even the men who walked up to the fire died. They didn't even go in the fire. And so he called them out. He said, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, come out here. What are you doing? And when they walked out of the fire, their clothes were not singed whatsoever. Not a hair on their head had been touched. And this is what's so cool to me. They didn't even smell like fire. They didn't even smell like smoke. You could not have even tell. Has anyone ever been camping and you can't get the smell of smoke out of your clothes for days? Literally happens to me every time I go camping. And it was just so cool to me to hear that there was no smell of fire on them. And this is so encouraging to me to hear that God is so powerful. The God that we are putting our trust in, he can save people. The smoke didn't even touch their clothes. He just wrapped themselves around them. And he sent that protector. Some say it might be Jesus. It might have been an angel. We don't know, because God is just so powerful and his plan for us is so amazing that he will save us from everything. And so that's why, back to when it says, but even if he does not, it's the trust. And it can be easy for us to trust in God if we acknowledge how powerful he is and how much he is willing to lay down for us. And so because of this bold action of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, because they stood up for what they believed in and they survived it because of God's power, King Nebuchadnezzar was in awe of this. He said, praise be to the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, who has sent his angel and rescued his servants. They trusted in him and defied their king's demand and were willing to give up their lives rather than to serve or worship any god but their own. And it's so cool to see how if we boldly act for God and for the glory of God and we stand out, we are impacting all the people around us. Just how this man who started at the beginning, he was very selfish man, always thinking about himself. He wanted people to bow down to him. He wanted people to worship his gods. This man is praising God. I imagine him just on his knees, begging for mercy from God. And it's so cool to see how just a bold action from followers of God can do this. And so it's cool to think about, you never know who you're influencing. When you act boldly, if you're you say something nice to someone, and it's just so random, you never know who you're influencing. You never know who's watching you. And so you might be planting seeds of Jesus everywhere, and you may not even know it. Just like how Shadrach and Meshach, they didn't know that this was going to turn into such a good thing. And so if we always are acting boldly for God, then we can plant seeds everywhere for him. We can shine Jesus's light everywhere we go. So, what I mainly got out of this is that bold actions glorify God. When we choose what God wants over what we want, when we choose to get out of our comfort zones and leave and don't conform to society, then we are standing up for what we believe in and we are acting boldly for God. And we are doing everything right, because if you choose the side that God is on, then you are choosing a good side. I can promise you that. And it's not always gonna be easy. It's not gonna be the best choice. You're not gonna look at it and be like, oh, like, you know, I'm just gonna leave all my friends and go do the opposite of what they're doing because God wants me to. Like, it's so difficult. But I'm gonna be honest, if your friends leave you because you're following God, they're probably not good friends, not gonna lie. But if we act boldly for glory of God, then we are choosing what he wants for us. And so we should set an example by acting boldly for others so that we can bring them to Christ. So some examples of bold actions of how we can do this in our daily lives is that we can be proactive servers. And so what this means is you're always looking around for ways that you can help other people. And so just an example of this is kind of what I talked about earlier. My mom is sitting at IHOP. She's eating her pancakes. She's having the best day of her life, her favorite holiday. And yet she's not just thinking about her food. She's not just thinking about her children probably being loud next to her. She's thinking of ways that she can serve other people. She sees that. No one had to come over and be like, hey, Lori, like, see that person? Can you go help them? No, she in her own mind knew God would want me to help them. And that is what proactive serving is. It's always looking for ways that you can go out and you can help someone. And the other thing is standing up for what you believe in. And we saw this in the story that I just told about Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, about where they stood up for what they believed in. And this is a bold action that glorified God. Another example of this is tomorrow is Juneteenth, and some are celebrating that, and that's a good example in history of how people stood up for what they believed in. They wanted all of God's people to be treated equally. They saw that all of God's people were equal and that they needed to be treated that way. And so they protested or they did different things, and because they stood strong in their beliefs and they stood up for what they believed in, they were able to bring the equality for everyone and to get rid of segregation and different aspects of life. And so it was just so amazing to see how if you stand up for the glory of God by doing the right thing, then you are impacting people and you're impacting all kinds of different areas in life. So just, this is what I really want you to get out of this. So everyone tune in for this part. Do the right thing for the glory of God, even if the outcome is not self-serving. I talked about how when I was a kid, I was very self-serving. I wanted people to look at me. I wanted people to say, like, oh, look at Addie, she's doing great. But that's not why we need to do the right thing. The reason we need to do the right thing is because we need to glorify God. And it's not gonna be easy, it's gonna be hard, but we just need to pray to God and ask him to help us, ask him to encourage us, because he's always gonna be there for us. We can trust in his power and his goodness, and it'll always be there. So, be a Shadrach, Meshach, or Abednego if you'd like to be an Abednego. I want you all to act boldly for God. I want you to all choose to get out of your comfort zone, and I want you to look for ways that you can help other people and that you can do the right thing. And so, I do have a challenge for you all that I want you to do this week. I want you to wake up every morning and pray. And I mean, my faith is probably different than all of y'all's faith. You can pray whatever you want, but there is a way I want you to start your prayer. I want you to say, Lord, show me the right way to live. Help my actions to glorify you in this day. So I want everyone to remember this, so I'm gonna say it one more time. Show me the right way to live. Help my actions to glorify you in this day. I want you to wake up and I want you to start your day thinking, how am I going to glorify God today? Because if you start your day thinking that, then you are going to find ways to glorify God. Because if you're always looking for it, you will find it, I can promise you. And so the more you pray and ask God to help you, the more he will help you and the more that you can act selflessly for him. So we are going to go into a time of reflection. And what I want you to think about during reflection are these two questions. One, I want you to think, are you always looking for ways to do the right thing? Are you choosing to stand out for God, or are you staying in your comfort zone? Are you going to fall in the ways of Jesus, or are you just going to sit back and watch everyone else do it? And two, what are your motives for doing the right thing? Are you putting your needs first, or are you thinking about God's plan for you? And when you do serve people, are you thinking about what you're going to get out of it, or are you thinking how you're going to glorify God? So before we do our reflection, I would like to pray for you. So if everyone could bow their heads. So thank you, God, for giving me the words to say. Thank you, Lord, for being with all of us. We trust in you, God, because you have never failed us. Lord, help that everyone can accept this challenge and boldly serve you as we go throughout this week and just our whole lives. Help us to set an example for those around us to show Christians how to truly act and live, and that we can act how your son lived. Sorry. Spark a flame of faith in this church and encourage your children to choose their faith over the ways of this world. Open their eyes to the sin and evil around them and help them to flee from it. Lord, help them that they can act boldly for you and that their intentions are pure. Fill them with your Holy Spirit so that they may be able to reflect you. Thank you for your example of how to live through sending your son to this earth, and thank you for this death so that we shall live forever. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.